Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I will talk about how to develop a full stack project using HTML, CSS, JavaScript, JSP and Oracle database. Look at this example. If we click on display, we can able to extract the data from the database. If we click on insert button, then user will able to provide the data, then those data will be inserted in the database. Let me check if we click on display button, no records found. It means that no data is stored in the database. If we click on back to home, we can able to insert the data. Click on insert button. It is redirected to the registration page. Here we can able to provide the user ID, name and branch. Provide user ID, provide name, provide branch. If you click on register button, this page will be redirected to the JSP applications. Here where the JSP application will insert the data. User registration successful. Then click on display. Then now whichever data have been inserted, those data will be retrieved over here. Then user ID, then name and branch. Let me check in the Oracle database also. Then select star from table name user 1. We click on run. See here, whichever data we have been taken from HTML page, those data has to be inserted in the database. This is index.html file where I created the two buttons. One button has been used for insert, another button is used for display. If you click on display, the onClick event has to be generated. The method will get executed where I am calling retrieve.jsp. If I click on the insert button, the onClick event has to be generated and insert method will be called where I am calling the user registration page. Let me explain the code. This is the registration page where we can provide the data. Then user ID, then we can able to provide the username, then we can able to provide the branch. If we click on the register, it has to be redirected to the insert.jsp where these data will be collected and those data will be stored in the database. This is insert.jsp file. The class.furname method is being used for loading the driver class. Then the second statement has been used for establish a connection with the Oracle server. I am using the type 4 driver, that is called a thin driver. The local host, the port number is 1521. XE stands for express edition. This is the username of the Oracle server and password of the Oracle servers. I received the data from the HTML file. The request.get parameter, the name attribute is ID. Then request.get parameter username has to be retrieved here. Then I also collected the branch. Insert into user 1, the fields are ID, name, branch. The values to be inserted. Here I am using the prepared statement for executing the queries. The first field to be inserted, second field to be inserted, then third field to be inserted. If it is integer, you can able to use set int method. If it is a string, we can able to use set string method. The 1, 2, 3, which are the fields, indexes. The way object name dot execute update, then the data will be inserted in the database. The user registration successful. Let me explain the retrieve.jsp. This statement has been used for loading the driver class. Then this statement has been used for connection establishment. Here I'm creating the statement object for executing the queries. Here I'm using the result set class for retrieving the data from the table in the database. This is query select star from user one. User one is the table name. We can able to retrieve all the rows from the table user one. The size is initialized to zero, rs.last. The cursor pointer is moves to the last field. The size equal to rs.getRow, getRow which is used to returns the row number. Then size greater than zero means few rows are available in the database, then we can able to retrieve the data from the database. Then otherwise, no records found. Here rs.next method, which is used to check whether row is available or not. If the row is available, see here, the first field is getInt method. The second field is a string, getString method is used. Then third field is also be string. I am using the getString method. If the row is available, those data will be returns. Then again, which will move on to the second row. Again, it will check whether row is available or not. The second row data will be displayed. Again, it check the condition. If the row is not available, then the loop will terminate. Once again, I will run the application. I click on insert. 102. Name is Surendra. Branch EC. Click on register. User registration is successful. Get back to the home. Click on display. Second row is also be inserted. If any doubt regarding this example, you may contact through the comment box. Thank you all for watching my videos. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.